things about DC generator. We have seen the definitions and the working principle, and then different types of DC machines. Then we came across the EMF equation of a DC generator. Today, we'll just directly come out the applications of a DC generator. And before that, even we can study for the characteristics of a shunt generators. So it is not in your syllabus, but you should know about what are the characteristics are going to happen when we are connected DC shunt generator. So already we know the parameter that VL or V, that IL load current and shunt field current ISH and armature current IA. So the graph should be plotted to see the what is the relations between voltage supply volume, that voltage which is coming to V and that particular IA, and what will be the relations between the voltage and shunt field current. So these are the characteristics we try to draw. Then we'll get some characteristics. That characteristics, even we can write down the equations, and we'll try to find out when we try to increase the armature current, what will be the voltage V, because we know that particular expression for shunt generator EG is equal to V minus IA RA. So that particular expression also we may get. So let us come with our first thing, that is application of DC shunt generator. So they will ask for 2 marks questions. Write down the few applications of DC generator. So directly you can just go through the because we have three type of DC generator: shunt, series and compound generator. So basically you just try to write down according to you can use for lightning and power supply process. No need to write that first line. If you open the first page of the that today's note, that DC shunt generator, so because of its slightly drooping characteristics, the shunt generator are suited for charging batteries and also parallel operations. So directly you can write down the DC shunt generators are maximum use for charging batteries and also for in parallel operation. It is also used for lightning and power supply purpose. And then it is also used for supplying the field current for regenerative braking of DC locomotives. So this particular DC regenerative braking and is one of branch like electrical branch students are there. When we'll come for the seventh semester, there is a one subject is there electrical drives. There we can find out the types of braking. There are various types of brakings are there. So from where we can find out what is regenerative braking, what is plugging, what is compound braking. So for the time being, you just it is used for supplying the field current to regenerative braking of DC motors and locomotives and DC compound generators. And rightly also you can write down these are the supply for railway circuits, elevator motors and incandescent lamps. And so that railway track, the traction particular position is a very important thing when you come for the high semester also. So you can understand what is the basic principle of a railway locomotive, how the train movement is moving in forward. And you can see the difference between the local train and the superfast train, because you can see if you just missed for 30 seconds or 40 seconds, you cannot catch the local train. And even you can miss for, if you are in hurry to take the, go for the washroom or take the drinking water. Suppose if you, the superfast train is just start journey, even you can run and you can take that particular train. So there is a basic difference between this local train and superfast train. Even there is a slightly a difference between, even also there is a luggage train also, that is that carrier train. It has, because it can carry maximum number of loads, but it cannot run faster. Whereas in the local train, and then every time, every 5 or 10 minutes, it can reach up to the speed up to 100 kilometer per hour. Even within a fraction of a second, it can do the braking very quickly. So these are the particular things out there, and where we can use this particular thing in a DC generator. There is lots of applications out there. Now coming to the problem number one, you just open the problem number one. So how to solve that type of problem? You just look that particular problem. Have you opened the problem number one?
Yes, sir.
Look very carefully at that particular problem. what is given, I'm just read out the problem. A four pole long shunt generator. So a four pole means what is the value of P? Four. Got it? Because yesterday we find two equations. Eg equals to P phi nz by 60A. So first value we are getting the a four pole long shunt generator. The value of P is 4 here. Next, long shunt generator. So you should remember long shunt generator. So the generator characteristics long shunt supplies 60 ampere at a terminal voltage. 60 ampere. What do you mean by 60 ampere? Which current that is? Who will tell me?
So primary.
It is not transformer. Now we are dealing with machine sector, not primary. Others, what current it is?
It's current.
Which current? Don't look the solutions.
It's current.
It is current, but which current I'm telling?
Series.
Why series current will come? Because this is a DC shunt generator, no? Why series is coming? Long shunt? So you are not following. Anyhow, let me come to the next person. At a terminal voltage of 400 volt, what is 400 volt here? The value of V is 400 volt. Okay. See, a four pole long shunt generator supplies 60 ampere current at a terminal voltage. 60 ampere current, that means that load current as 60 ampere, and the voltage V is 400 volt. The armature resistance is 0.01. Okay, the armature resistance is 0.01. So what do you mean by armature resistance? How to define, how to express? Armature resistance is expressed as RA. Okay, RA. Are you following? RA. Now, then shunt field resistance. Shunt field resistance, what is the name? How do you express shunt field resistance? RSH. Are you following or not? Or shall I share from mobile? Wait.
Sir, we are following.
Someone are not able to following. Let me share. Screen is shared?
Yes, sir.
Just hold on. Because someone joining late, so not able to find out what sir is going to tell. Mobile screen is very... Can you able to see now?
Sir, rotate kore nin, onek choto lagacche.
Ami etai bhoy pachhilam.
Sir, rotate kore nin phone ta.
Rotate kore nebo, tara korchi.
Ha, ebar thik ache. Ebar thik ache.
Ei je problem ta, ei problem ta dekha jacche. Ei problem ta ami porchhilam. A four pole long shunt generator supplies 60 ampere as a terminal voltage. So the value of P is 4 here. আর সাপ্লাইস 60 অ্যাম্পিয়ার এট এ টার্মিনাল ভোল্টেজ টার্মিনাল ভোল্টেজটা হচ্ছে আমার ভি ভ্যালু ইজ ভি ইজ 400 ভোল্ট টার্মিনাল ভোল্টেজ দ্যাট ইজ নাথিং বাট দ্য টার্মিনাল ভোল্টেজ দ্যাট 60 অ্যাম্পিয়ার কারেন্ট সো দ্যাট ইজ লোড কারেন্ট সো উই হ্যাভ টু ড্র ওয়েন উই ট্রাই টু ড্র দ্য লং শান্ট জেনারেটর দেন উই ক্যান ফাইন্ড আউট ওয়ার দ্য আইএল ইজ দেয়ার ওয়ার দ্য ভি ইজ দেয়ার ওহো দিস ইজ দ্য প্রবলেম কোন দিকে চলে গেল Now, then armature resistance is 0.01 ohm. 0.01. So that means value of RA is 0.0 ohm and series field resistance is 0.02 ohm. Series field means RAC and shunt field resistance is 100. That is RSH. Find the generated EMF taking the brass drop as 1 volt per brass. Neglect the armature reaction drop. So let us draw the particular circuit diagram. So is it the circuit diagram for long shunt? Is it clear? Check. This is a shunt generator. Try to look the figure. Is it clear? Figure. You try to look the figure very carefully. Am I audible, na?
Yes, sir.
From that particular figure, can you able to find out what they are telling? See, you can see that 100 ohm, this 100 ohm left hand side, that is shunt field resistance, and R, then, and this is 60 ampere current, that is given now, 60 ampere current terminal voltage. Then the armature resistance is 0.01, which is there. This directly that armature is written in between that round circle, 0.01 ohm. And the series field resistance is 0.02 ohm. Just hold 1 second. What do you call? From the figure, if anybody didn't understand what is the notation of that practical figure, you please tell me so that I can make you understand. So this is the figure for DC shunt generator, where we can see the armature resistance is 0.01 ohm and shunt field resistance, that is 100 ohm, that is left hand side of the side, 60 ampere current, that is supply current. This current is nothing but IL, and you can see the armature resistance is given in the problem, that is 0.01 ohm. And what they are trying to find out, find the generated EMF. So they are find out what is the value of EG. Okay. So basically they are trying to tell that what is the value of EG. So from that long shunt generator, if you see the last expression, EG is equal to V plus IA RA plus series drop plus brass drop. If you try to remember that particular expression from the last class, so this is the final expression. EG is equal to V plus IA RA plus series drop plus brass drop. Now V value is given. V value is given from the problem, that is 400 volt. Armature current is given. Armature current is not given. Okay. So they are given the current IL. So what is the formula for armature current? Can anybody tell me quickly? Armature current is nothing but IL plus ISH. Did you remember?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So IL plus ISH. So IL value is given. ISH is not given. How to find out ISH? V by RSH. Value of V is given. 400 volt. And RA and RSH is also given. Is it right? See, the current flowing through the shunt field winding is given by ISH is equal to V by RSH. Value of V is 400 volt and RSH value is 100. So ISH current is 4 ampere current. So the current through the armature and the series field winding is Ia is equal to Ish plus IL. So what is, so that means 64 ampere. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now come to the last expression. Eg is equal to V plus IaRa plus sheet drop plus brass drop. So V value is given. Ia just now we got Ia into Ra. Ra value we know 0.01 ohm. Series drop is, that is also we have to find out. Series drop means that Isc, see here Isc and that particular current, and Isc means that current is Ia, is nothing, Ia is equal to Isc, because you can see that Isc value, that armature current and series, this you can see from the armature there was a spring type of knee, that is nothing but Rac value. So you can see from the figure Ia and Isc value is same. So Isc into that value is Rac. So this is series drop. You can find out, so 64 into 0.02, that is 1.28 volt. That is third portion. V plus IRA plus series drop. And brass drop, they are given as a brass drop is 2 into 1 volt. So there are two brass. You can see from the figure that two black portions from that ball, the where the armature is written. So this is 1 plus 2, 1 into 2. So Eg is equal to this. If you write down the particular formula, so you can find out 403.92. Is it clear?
Sir, students join होने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं sir.
यही तो मुश्किल है ना मोबाइल में. देखता हूँ फिर कैसे उसको. एक लैपटॉप कभी-कभी धोखा देता है. हो गया? अच्छा ये प्रॉब्लम समझ में आया ना? एक प्रॉब्लम समझ में आया, ये वाला प्रॉब्लम?
यस सर.
देख लो, कैन आई गो फॉर नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम?
यस
सर.
See this particular problem. Carefully see. What they are given? A 20 kilowatt and 200 kilovolt. A 200 kilovolt generation. It is not kilovolt. It is only 200 volt. Okay. A 20 kilowatt, 200 volt DC shunt generator has armature and field resistance is 0.05 ohm and 150 ohm respectively. Determine the total armature power developed when the machine works as a generator, delivering 20 kilowatt of output. So first try to note it down, what are the particular given data in the problem. So they are directly given that 20 kilowatt. 20 kilowatt is nothing but the power. So given input power is PL is 20 into 10 power 3. Okay. Input voltage 200 kilovolt. It is not KV, it is only 200 volt. So VL is 200 volt. Okay. They have given the armature field resistance and armature resistance and field resistance. That means value of Ra and Rsh is also given, because this is a DC shunt generator. So the value of Rsh. So Ra, Rsh is given. Now determine the total armature power developed. Armature power developed means what would be the formula? Armature power developed. We know the armature power. That means we have to find out Eg into Ia. So that is armature power. Right now, last expression of what we find out, that is Eg. That is generated EMF. It is, this generated EMF is nothing but the armature voltage. You can see that Eg is generated voltage or armature voltage. You can directly see. So if you try to multiply Eg into Ia, so we can get the armature developed power. So let us find out in the same way what we did. As because Rsh is given, so from there we will find out the value of Ish. Okay, and that current IL also we will get it PL by VL. So 100 ampere. So armature current, we find out just IL plus ISH as previous from the previous problem. Then EG is equal to VL plus IARA. Why VL plus IARA? Because in this particular problem, there is no brass drop. So directly you can write down VL plus IARA, and there is no series drop also. So directly you can find out EG is equal to VL plus IA into RA. Okay. Then armature power developed is equal to EG into IA. So that particular EG into IA. Is it clear? Or I'll little bit faster for this problem.
Sir, repeat कर दीजिए sir.
ठीक है पहले इसको देखो. इस problem में they have given that power, they have given the voltage, they have given the armature resistance, they have given the field resistance. हमको यहाँ से armature power का develop armature power कितना होता है? Only that is our concern. So when they are given the power, they are given the voltage. So we can find out directly find out the value of IL. So IL is equal to nothing but PL by VL. So PL value is given 20 kilowatt and VL is 200 volt. So from that particular expression from IL, we are finding out. So this particular IL is equal to PL by VL, 100 ampere. Okay. And we know for the DC shunt generator, the value of shunt field current, that is ISH, is equal to VL by RSH. So VL value is 200 volt and RSH value is 150 volt. That is also given in the problem. So ISH we got 1.33, IL we got 100 ampere. So armature current according to DC shunt generator, armature current equals to load current plus shunt field current. So we got that particular 101.33 volt. Now what will be the generated EMF, induced EMF? So induced EMF in case of DC shunt generator, that particular expression EG is equal to VL plus IARA. In last problem, we have dropped the series drop, and that is brass voltage drop. But in this particular problem, there is no series drop, no brass voltage drop. So directly you can find out, write down the expression EG is equal to VL plus IARA. So 200 plus that particular thing IARA into this. So we got 205.06. Now armature power developed is nothing but EG into IA. EG into IA means what? Just now we got value of EG, and we know the armature current IA. So just you multiply, you can get the armature power developed. Is it clear now?
Yes sir.
ठीक है, अगर इसको और एक बार देख लो, मैं जहां से नोट भेजा हूं वहां से एक बार देख लो, मुझे फिर एक मिनट के लिए मुझे फिर साइलेंट होना है फिर. ठीक है, देखो फिर मैं नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम में आता हूं. Still someone is coming. Is it clear? Last वाला problem जो था, आप लोगों सबको समझ में आया?
यस सर
ठीक है अब प्रॉब्लम नंबर थ्री में आते हैं ठीक है इज इट विजिबल प्रॉब्लम नंबर थ्री
यस सर
यस सर
ओके देखो क्या लिखा है ए फोर पोल लैप उंड डीसी शंट जनरेटर रिमेंबर लास्ट जो प्रॉब्लम में था वहां पर कुछ उंड नहीं था लैप उंड नहीं था वेब उंड नहीं था यहां पर लैप उंड हो गया फिर ठीक है मैं लास्ट क्लास बोला था देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ वाइंडिंग इज देयर लैप वाइंडिंग and web winding. So in this particular problem, they have given the DC shunt generator and the connection is lap winding. So this is the difference. You have to identify what is the difference from the previous one. Now, four pole lap wound DC shunt generator has useful flux per pole is 0.08 Weber. So value of P is how much? 4. Okay. Now, in case of lap wound, what is the number of parallel path? Because there is one term is there, that is A is number of parallel path. So value of A will be is equal to value of P, number of poles. Okay. Now look the useful flux per pole. That means what? What is the value of flux? That is phi. Phi is equal to how much? 0.08 Weber. The armature winding consists of 200 turns. The armature winding consists of 200 turns. With a total resistance of 0.8 ohm. This particular line you just see very carefully. Then they are asking calculate the terminal voltage when running at 1000 RPM if the armature current is 50 ampere. So they have given the speed, they have also given in the n value is given and the armature current is also given, that is IA is also given. So they have given the value of Z. Not given, we have to find out the value of Z. They have already given the value of number of poles, number of parallel path and flux they have given. So we have to apply the appropriate formula to find out the exact what you call that question mark. We have to find out in that way. So what is their question? Calculate the terminal voltage when running at 1000 RPM if the armature current is 50 ampere. So we have to find out the generated EMF, that is EG. So in the last two problem we have find out the formula EG is equal to V plus IA RA, but here they have given that flux value. So flux value they have given, that means that we have to use some different formula to find out that generated EMF. So what is that particular formula? EG is equal to P phi NZ by 60A. So you can see this particular formula EG is equal to P phi NZ by 60A. Now value of phi is given. Value of Z is directly not given. Number of conductor is directly not given. That N value, that speed is also given. P is also given. Number of poles. A, we know the number of parallel path. So only thing, only concerned about that, find out the number of conductors, Z. What will be the number of conductors? Now look the particular problem very carefully. The armature winding consists of 200 turns with a total resistance of 0.8 ohm. So the armature winding, you can show that the number of parallel path conductor. Amra last class we have seen that conductor, how is it placed? It is just parallel of that. So number of conductor is nothing but total number of conductors, Z is equal to 200 into 2, because they have given only the armature winding consists of 200 turns. So total number of conductors, Z is equal to 200 into 2, that is 400. The next problem also we'll try to find out. They will also give you the number of slot. Here number of slot is not given, so directly they have given the number of turns on the winding. So just we have to multiply it by 2 to get the number of conductors. So value of Z is equal to 200 into 2, so 400 watt. Other than all value are known to us. So you just apply the formula and you try to get down the value of EG is equal to that particular value.
The total number of conductor
দেখো কালকে আমরা যখন লাস্ট ক্লাসে সোমবার আমরা যখন দেখেছিলাম যে কন্ডাক্টরটা কিভাবে প্লেসড হয়, একটা উপরে থাকলে একটা নিচে হয়, জাস্ট উপরে যেটা থাকে তার সিমেট্রিটা নিচে থাকে, সেই জন্য এখানে বলেছে যে ওয়েন্ডিংটা যেটা থাকবে সেটা নিচেও যেটা থাকবে সেটা উপরে যেটা থাকে, সেই জন্য টোটাল আমার হচ্ছে দা আর্মেচার ওয়েন্ডিং কনসিস্ট অফ 200 টার্নস, দ্যাট মিন্স আমার যে এটা যেটা হবে জাস্ট এটাকে মাল্টিপ্লাইড বাই 2 করতে হবে, বুঝতে পারছো তো? সেই জন্য এটা সেটা সেই জন্য এটা 400 হয়েছে। তো আমি যখন ভ্যালু অফ ইজিটা পেয়ে গেলাম, এইটাই আবার ভ্যালু অফ ইজি যখন পেয়ে গেলাম তখন আমি আমার পক্ষে কোনো আর অসুবিধে নেই, দেন উই হ্যাভ টু ফাইন্ড আউট দ্যাট পার্টিকুলার ফর্মুলা। কি ফর্মুলা রয়েছিল আমার, ইজি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু কি ছিল, ভি প্লাস আই আর ছিল না একটা ফর্মুলা যেটা আমরা আগে করেছিলাম, দেখো ভিজি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু কি ছিল আমার এখানে, ইজি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু ভি প্লাস আই আর। তো আমরা এখানে প্রথমে ইজির ভ্যালুটা বের করে নিলাম, ইজির ভ্যালুটা বের করে নিলে আমাকে ভি এর ভ্যালুটা বার করতে বলেছে, সরি আমাকে এখানে আমি যেটা তোমাকে বলতে ভুল করেছিলাম, এখানে বলেছে ক্যালকুলেট দ্য টার্মিনাল ভোল্টেজ। সো টার্মিনাল ভোল্টেজ মানে হচ্ছে ভ্যালু অফ ভি উই হ্যাভ টু ফাইন্ড আউট। সো ভ্যালু অফ ভি হাউ টু ফাইন্ড আউট, ইন সেম ওয়ে ইজি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু ভি প্লাস আই আর, অথবা ভি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু লিখতে পারি ইজি মাইনাস আই আর, সেম ফর্মুলা, অ্যাপ্লিকেশন অফ সেম ফর্মুলা। নাও আর্মেচার কারেন্ট, আর্মেচার কারেন্ট দে হ্যাভ গিভেন দ্য আর্মেচার কারেন্ট, ইয়েস দে হ্যাভ গিভেন দ্য আর্মেচার কারেন্ট ইজ 50 অ্যাম্পিয়ার, লাস্ট লাইন ইউ ক্যান সি দ্য প্রবলেম, ইফ দ্য আর্মেচার কারেন্ট ইজ 50 অ্যাম্পিয়ার, সো আই এ ভ্যালু ইজ গিভেন এন্ড দ্য আর এ ভ্যালু ইজ অলসো গিভেন, আর এ ভ্যালু ইজ টোটাল রেজিস্ট্যান্স ইজ 0.8 ওহম, রাইট, দে হ্যাভ গিভেন আই এ ইন্টু আর এ, ওয়াই ইজ 0.04, ওকে 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 ওকে, উই হ্যাভ টু ফাইন্ড দ্যাট পার্টিকুলার থিং অলসো। নাও সি দ্য টোটাল নাম্বার, দ্য টোটাল আর্মেচার রেজিস্ট্যান্স ইজ 0.8 ওহম, সি 200 turns with a total resistance of 0.8 ohm. So since there are four parallel path and each path has the resistance 0.8 by 4. Why number of parallel path A is equal to 4? Because it is a lap wound generator. So value of A is equal to value of P in this particular C. See P is equal to A is equal to 4 because number of parallel path is 4. So the total resistance is nothing but total resistance is how much? Total resistance is that there are four number of parallel path. Each parallel path resistance is 0.8 by 4, 0.2 ohm. The equivalent resistance of the four parallel path, that is 0.2 ohm in each parallel path, will be 0.2 by 4, that is 0.05 ohm resistance. So total armature resistance is coming 50 into 0.05. So that is come 2.5 volt. Okay. Now you apply the formula V equal to Eg minus IAR, you will get that supply voltage. Now these two lines, you may get some doubt. So sir, আমাকে টোটাল আর্মেচার রেজিস্ট্যান্স এটা দিল, কিন্তু আমি যখন আর্মেচার ড্রপ যখন করছি আমাদের পার্টিকুলার ভ্যালু অফ রেজিস্ট্যান্স আর যেটা হচ্ছে সেটাতে এতগুলো ভাগ কেন হলো, দ্যাট মাইট বি দ্য কোশ্চেন্স, বিকজ অ্যাজ দিস ইজ এ ল্যাপ উন জেনারেটার, সো নাম্বার অফ প্যারালাল পাথ, নাম্বার অফ প্যারালাল পাথ, হাউ মেনি নাম্বার অফ প্যারালাল পাথ আর স্যার দেয়ার, দেয়ার আর ফোর নাম্বার অফ প্যারালাল পাথ আর দেয়ার, সো টোটাল রেজিস্ট্যান্স উইল বি ডিভাইডেড বাই ফোর, ইচ প্যারালাল পাথ হ্যাভিং 0.2 ওহম রেজিস্ট্যান্স। আবার কি বলছে, দ্য ইকুইভ্যালেন্ট রেজিস্ট্যান্স অফ দ্য ফোর প্যারালাল যদি হয় তাহলে একটা সিঙ্গেল পাথের জন্য কি হবে, ইচ প্যারালাল পাথের জন্য 0.2 কে আবার 4 দিয়ে ডিভাইড করতে হবে এন্ড উইল গেট ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল আর্মেচার রেজিস্ট্যান্স, সো দ্যাট ভ্যালু ইজ 0.05 ওহম। সো ওয়ান্স উই ফাইন্ড আউট দ্যাট 0. আর এ ভ্যালু ইজ 0.05 ওহম, সো আর্মেচার ড্রপ ইজ ইন দিস পার্টিকুলার এক্সপ্রেশন ভি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু ইজি মাইনাস আই আর এ, ইজি ভ্যালু অলরেডি উই ফাইন্ড আউট ফ্রম দ্যাট পার্টিকুলার ফর্মুলা, ইজি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু পি ফাই এন জেড বাই 60 এ, IA value we know that is given in the problem, RA value just now we find out. So if you apply this particular formula, so you will get the supply voltage that is nothing but 530.83 volt. Okay. Is it clear? You just practice twice or thrice, you can able to understand. Can I proceed for the next problem?
Yes, sir.
Now, this problem is the same problem, but instead of lap wound connected, they have given wave wound generator. Now, let us see what is the changes in this particular problem. They have given a 4 pole. The value of P is how much? 4. Wave wound generator mein kya hota hai? Number of parallel path A is equal to hamesha 2 rehta hai. Isi wajah se A is equal to 2 for wave wound. Ho gaya. DC generator has 50 slots. यहाँ पर देखो slots दे दिया है and 24 conductors.
Hello sir.
Okay. Yes yes. Tell me.
I think sir there is some technical issue. We are getting half of the PDF notes.
Yes sir. Look.
Is it coming or not?
No sir. Half is coming. Half of the portion is coming, sir.
Screen rotated.
Still half of the screen is shared. Some technical issue maybe. Oh. Now it's okay.
Now it's okay.
Yes, sir. Now it's okay.
Okay, now see, in this particular problem number 4, they have given Weibull generator. In Weibull generator, the number of parallel paths is equal to 2, and number of pole is given in the problem, P is equal to 4. Okay, now they have given the generator has 50 slots and 24 conductors. 50 slots means 50 slots and 24 conductor per slot. So total number of conductor will be just 24 into 50, because they have given 50 slots and 24 conductors per slot. So total number of conductors will be 24 into 50. Okay, so that is number of conductor, that is Z. Now flux per pole is 10 milliweber. Flux per pole is 10 milliweber, that means that is a value of phi. Now determine the induced EMF in the armature if the rotating at a speed of 600 rpm. So value of N is also given. So what we have to find out? We have to find out the induced EMF. Induced EMF formula is what? Eg. Eg is equal to P phi Nz by 60A. You just write, you just put the all the data and get the exact equations for the exact value of induced EMF. So 240 volt. Is it clear? I think it's a very simple problem. No need to worry. Worry about how to find out the total number of conductors is the conductor is given in terms of slot or conductor per slot. That is the only tricks here. Can I proceed next?
Yes, sir.
Fine.
Yes, sir.
See, this is also same type of problem, but in case of supply voltage or induced EMF, they are trying to find out what will be the speed. So that means all value will be given. Expect that particular. Question mark, that is speed. Let us read the problem. A 6-pole wave wound means the value of A will be 2, has 780 conductors. Okay, so see here, they have given the value of conductor directly. So value of Z is 780 conductor, and flux of 12 milliweber. So flux is 12 milliweber. 12 means that is value of phi. Find the speed of the armature. Find the speed of the armature when the generated EMF is 400 volt. So generated EMF is also given 400 volt. What will be the speed when it is lap wound? So we have to find out the speed when the generator connection in lap wound. Initially it was wave wound. On that time speed was like how much is given? Speed is given. Find the speed. Oh. Screen time out now. So in first case, we have find the speed of the armature when the generated EMF is 400 volts. So let us find out the first one. So the value of number of pole is 6, wave wound. So value of A is 2. Armature conductor Z is also given. Phi is also given. So E is also given. Induced EMF 400 volt to calculate in. So we have to find out, we have to write the expression. E is equal to P phi Nz by 60A. From here, we have to find out what is the value of N. So speed, we will find out the N in that way. So we got 854.70 RPM. Is it clear? Tomra shobai bujhte pachho kibhabe holo eta? Amra just we have just write down the yes. 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 Agetar motoi problem. Instead of EG, we have to find out the value of
N.
অর্ধেকটা দেখা যাচ্ছে, আমি তোমাদের নোটস দিয়ে দিয়েছি, আবার অর্ধেক দেখা যাচ্ছে, নেটওয়ার্ক ইস্যু, এবার আর পারা যাচ্ছে না, আমি ওই
এবার ঠিক আছে,
হ্যাঁ স্যার ঠিক আছে স্যার,
ওকে ঠিক আছে, আচ্ছা আচ্ছা সেকেন্ড কেসটা কি বলেছে দেখো, হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য স্পিড ওয়েন ইট ইজ ল্যাপ উন্ড, যখন ল্যাপ উন্ড হবে তখন আমার কি হয়ে যাবে, ভ্যালু অফ পিটা হয়ে যাবে, ভ্যালু অফ এ হয়ে যাবে, তখন আমার স্পিডটা বের করতে হবে, তখন স্পিডটা আমার সেম ফর্মুলা তো বের করব, দেখো এখানে লিখেছি ইন ল্যাপ উন্ড এর ক্ষেত্রে ভ্যালু অফ এ ইজ ইকুয়াল টু পি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু 6 এন্ড এন উইল বি দ্য সেম থিং P phi Nz by 60A, 60 এর ভ্যালুর জায়গায় আমার ওই এর ভ্যালুটা হয়ে যাচ্ছে, এর ভ্যালুটা হয়ে যাচ্ছে আমার 6 হয়ে যাচ্ছে, দিয়ে আমি যে স্পিডটা পাবো সেটা হচ্ছে আমার RPM. তোমরা যখন এক্সামে যখন অ্যাকচুয়াল অ্যান্সার যখন লিখবে তখন পয়েন্ট RPMটাকে যেমন 8854.70 RPM এটাকে ডাইরেক্টলি লিখবে 80 নিয়ারলি ইকুয়াল টু 8855 RPM, আর এখানে লিখবে সেকেন্ড কেসে লিখবে 2564 RPM. ওকে, তো এই প্রবলেমটা ক্লিয়ার, কোনো অসুবিধা নেই কারকার. It's a very simple type of problem. If you try to remember the necessary formula for a DC shunt generator, then you can solve any numericals. And this numerical 7 marks and and it will not take much time while solving and your answer in a correct manner. Okay, let us come with the now. I'm not going the problem number 6 because it's very similar to you. Just treat. You will try to understand how to find out the same thing in same way they have done that particular things. So no need to worry about that. I'll just give you the note. You just practice it and you will find out the things. Okay. Similarly, 7, 8. There is a variety of problem that are given. So all are related to the theoretical portion. There is a not a single what you call that problem which is not done in theoretically. So and this problem number 10 you try to skip. No need to wipe and no need to study for your exam point of view. Okay, problem number 10. Now let us come with the DC motor. Now we have listened that the DC generator. Now we have to come through the DC motor. So initially that conversion of energy and it is just reverse of that DC generator. So what do you mean by that? So motor changes electrical energy into mechanical energy. In case of DC generator, what we did, mechanical energy into electrical energy. So whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, a force will act on the conductor and whose magnitude is given by F is equal to BIL sine theta. I think you have slightly know about this particular thing, F equals to BIL sine theta. In your 10 plus 2 physics, you have, I think, studied this particular expressions. Where B is the flux density in Weber per meter square, and I is the current in ampere, and L is the length of the conductor in meter, and theta is the angle between the conductor and the field, and the direction of the force is given by Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, so principle of DC motor, you just read it from this particular notes. There is no tough thing. So principle of DC motor. Now this particular thing will come the back EMF. This is very important for your exam point of view. What do you mean by back EMF? So initially, in case of